Spiders are found all over the planet, on every continent except Antarctica. As of September 2023, there are 51,450 recognized species. They range from the very tiny to the reasonably large. And while over 50,000 sounds like we've discovered a lot, and I guess we have, according to the World Spider Catalog, there are still approximately 50,000 more spider species out there to discover. And that's the lower estimate. Others like Linda Rayer, a behavioral ecologist at Cornell University, thinks only about a third of the estimated 150,000 to 180,000 species have been discovered. We know of some big spiders on Earth today that are recognized and cataloged by science, but could there be bigger ones yet to be officially discovered? And by bigger, I mean much bigger. We're talking about spiders the size of a dog. There are reports of giant spiders from different continents around the world. Today, we are going to be looking at some of these sightings and trying to determine if they are possible. Could some spiders get extra big? To help me with this video, I have the excellent YouTuber and cryptid enthusiast, Truth is Scarier Than Fiction, to help me look at some of these sightings.
The most infamous of all giant spiders is the Jabba Fofi. You may be familiar with the story of Arthur Symes, a missionary who allegedly witnessed a Jabba Fofi kill several people. While this story has become popular online, it actually originated in a work of cryptozoological fiction in 2002. The real story of the Jabba Fofi begins in 1938, when two explorers in the Congo witnessed a monkey-sized spider crawl out of the woods and pass in front of them on the road. Cryptozoologist Bill Gibbons later interviewed the Baka people about the cryptid. One of them said that the Jabba Fofi had been spotted back in 2003. Interestingly, young Jabba Fofis were described as being yellow with a purple abdomen, turning brown as they grew up. In 1948, a family in Louisiana was walking along a highway when they spotted a large spider described as being the size of a washtub. It walked across the road and disappeared into the brush. Another sighting in Louisiana involved soldiers training with night vision. While using it, they spotted a spider the size of a trash can cover crawl across a trail. In 2013, a man who was fishing on the Missouri River spotted a large and bizarre spider-like creature. He had sat down when he heard the sound of dry leaves being moved. He then turned and spotted the creature, which he said was about 5 feet or 1.5 meters wide and had long hairy legs. It also moved very fast like a spider. As it grabbed the canteen he had just set on the ground and left in only a few seconds. In the Dominican Republic, a couple was staying at a hotel when the husband walked out of the bathroom and told his wife that there was a spider in the sink. When she walked into the bathroom, she noticed hairy 10-inch or 25-centimeter long legs sticking out of the sink that were black and orange in color. She and her husband estimated that it was well over 2 feet or 60 centimeters long. She went to get assistance from the hotel staff, and by that point the spider had left. The show Monster Quest covered an expedition into Venezuela to investigate giant spider reports. One man stated that he had seen a spider that, when it reared up, was about the size of a man. In another village, two people claimed that a child's disappearance was due to giant spiders. In 2011, cinematographer Richard Terry heard reports of horse-eating spiders in Colombia. Professor Percy Podmore, a fellow of the Zoological Society of London, also wrote about a man-eating spider in modern-day Suriname. After being blamed for a missing girl, the spider ambushed and killed a man. The villagers then stormed the cave it lived in and set the entrance on fire. When the spider began to rush out of the cave, a man threw a hatchet at it. The spider gushed so much blood that the fire was half extinguished for a moment, before it recovered and consumed the creature. American cryptozoologist Craig Woolheater was told of a story about soldiers in the Vietnam War coming across giant spiders. They were 30 inches or 75 centimeters wide and lived near bodies of water. The soldiers fired at them, but despite shooting off full magazines from their M16s, the spiders survived. In 1944, an Australian soldier was stationed in Papua New Guinea when he came across a large web. It had a cotton-like consistency and seemed to stretch up to 15 feet or 4.5 meters in either direction. He then saw the spider, which was directly in front of his face. It was around the size of a small dog, jet black in color, and had hairy legs. He then carefully backed away. Another testimony came from the grandson of a World War II soldier. He said that his grandfather encountered a 3-foot or 1 meter long spider. Curiously, it was shiny and emerald green in color. He hacked it to death with a machete. Around 2001, a librarian named Sheila was driving by an abandoned factory near Nottingham, England. As she approached, her headlights illuminated what she at first thought was a hedgehog. Upon closer inspection, she realized it was a massive tarantula, about 2 feet or 60 centimeters wide. It scurried across the road and into the factory. For all of Wild World's English viewers, you can rest a little easier, since the factory has since been demolished.
We weren't too sure if we should include this cryptid, but in the icy waters of Greenland and the Canadian Arctic, locals share tales of a creature known as Kajanok, a mysterious giant aquatic arachnid known as Azavarlut to the Canadian Inuit. It's described as a massive sea spider resembling a huntsman lurking near the seabed to ambush seals. In western Greenland, it's described as a sea scorpion, the size of boats in lakes Natsilik and Umanak. While skeptics doubt its identity as a Eurypterid, some suggest it might be a surviving stellar sea cow, which I don't really see, but apparently this is due to them sometimes being described as upturned boats, which I guess I could see that. Or a type of sculpin, which is a type of fish, which I guess from some angles it could resemble it? I don't know. According to The Hidden, a compendium of Arctic giants, dwarves, gnomes, trolls, fairies, and other strange beings from Inuit oral history, a kayaker near Baffin Island claimed a sighting in the early 20th century. He paddled away as fast as possible as he had heard how dangerous ocean spiders were to kayakers. The details, though, are very brief and vague. I find some of the possible explanations a little odd, like the extinct stellar sea cow or a fish. If it was misidentification, wouldn't something more like a lobster be a possible suspect? The Homarus americanus is found in coastal areas around Canada to New Jersey and lives on rocks at depths of 2 to 40 meters, 6.6 feet to 131 feet. Considering it can be found at shallower depths and lobsters can grow somewhat large, and the general shape, I think it's a little more likely to be a contender. But there is another question about these giants. Is it even possible? Perhaps to get a sense of how big spiders can get, it is worth looking at some of the largest known spiders for reference. In terms of leg span, it is generally accepted that the giant huntsman spider has the largest leg span. Now, when we hear the word huntsman, many of us think of Australia. But while they certainly have a variety of huntsman species, the largest known species is the giant huntsman, Heteropoda maxima, found in the caves of Laos. According to an article on the Royal Society, it has a leg span of approximately 30 centimeters, or 12 inches. Now that's pretty impressive, but when it comes to the biggest, we need to look at overall mass, and by that criteria, the actual biggest species of spider would be the Goliath bird-eating spider, a spider that, despite its name, rarely eats birds in the wild. Interestingly enough, there are actually three species of spider that you might find at an expo or being sold as a Goliath bird eater: Theraphosa blondii, Theraphosa apophysis, and Theraphosa sturmi. Though generally speaking, when we say Goliath bird eater, we are referring to Theraphosa blondii, which also has a leg span close to the giant huntsman. Actually, some sources say it meets and exceeds it, but more importantly, it is considered the heaviest spider, with some sources saying, claiming, It can weigh 175 grams, or 6.2 ounces. So Theraphosa blondii is the one to beat. Of course, Theraphosa blondii is a New World tarantula, but on the African continent, the king baboon spider can have a leg span of up to 20 centimeters, or 7.9 inches. So no modern known spider really gets anywhere near the giant spider sightings.
No.
But what about in the past? Did spiders ever get that large? Not really.
No.
Or at least it doesn't seem like they did. We don't really have anything super huge in the fossil record. The biggest fossil spider we found seems to be Nephila jurassica, which would have had a leg span of some 15 centimeters or 5.9 inches from the family Nephilinae, like the golden orb-weeb spiders we have today. We recently had the new discovery in Australia's McGraw's Flat. Scientists found a new giant fossil spider named Megamonodontium mccullskii, dating back 11 to 16 million years, resembling the living genus Monodontium, a brush-footed trapdoor spider, but dwarfing it by 5 times. This arachnid measures 50 millimeters from toe to toe, which is 5 centimeters or 1.97 inches, so smaller than Nephila jurassica, and a pretty small giant compared to Theraphosa blondii. Now, some of you might be thinking about Megarachne, as featured in Walking with Monsters, with a body length of 54 centimeters or 21 inches. However, further research revealed Megarachne was actually a Eurypterid, sometimes called a sea scorpion, though it was found in strata that indicates freshwater. Apparently, the creators of Walking with Monsters learned of this discovery before the show was finished, but they were so far along in production, they just went with it. But are spiders as big as Jabba Fofi even possible? Now, there are a few issues with the viability of a spider getting this large. Spiders have an exoskeleton, which is generally a pretty good thing for arthropods, as it offers them protection. However, it isn't quite as effective if you get very large. The bigger it gets, the thicker the exoskeleton would have to be to support the excess weight. But what's the limit? How big could a terrestrial arthropod get? Well, the largest arthropod on land is the coconut crab, aka the robber crab, Burgus latro, which is reported to weigh up to 4 or 5 kilos, 9 to 11 pounds. And the distance between one leg tip to another can reportedly be up to 1 meter or 3 feet 3 inches. So coconut crabs kind of seem to be around the size of what some of these giant spiders are claimed to be. And if a crab could get that big, why couldn't a spider? Well, coconut crabs have a different respiratory system and body structure that allows them to support their size more effectively. Unlike spiders, which rely on book lungs or a tracheal system for respiration, or sometimes both, coconut crabs have evolved a modified respiratory system that enables them to grow larger. As tarantulas grow larger, their bodies become thicker and heavier, which constrain the capacity of their book lungs to provide sufficient oxygen to their tissues. While some tarantulas can have relatively large book lungs, even these have limitations. The inability of book lungs to actively expand or contract like a diaphragm restricts their efficiency. The idea of giant spiders is certainly very exciting, but there seem to be a lot of limiting factors when it comes to size, and misidentification is always that annoying thing in cryptozoology that is a bit of a buzzkill. With coconut crabs and PNG, I can imagine them being mistaken for spiders, though the stories with the cobwebs do make it interesting. For other spiders like Jabba Fofi, well, I think it could be real, but I don't think they are quite as large as described. Here's the thing, as mentioned, there are still many, many spiders yet to be discovered. An electric blue tarantula was recently discovered in Thailand. I think there is a good chance a big tarantula could be in the Congo that hasn't been discovered yet, or at least discovered by modern science. Bigger than Theraphosa blondii? I don't know, maybe, but if it is, I doubt it is by much. And we also have reports from Maine and Azores of secretive, large spiders, but rather than dog-sized, they are described more around the size of the Goliath bird eater. Again, could be real spiders, but bird eaters, which are in the tarantula family, generally need a reasonably warm climate. There are also reports of other cryptid spiders, not giants but bioluminescent spiders, from Myanmar and India, and I don't find that to be too unbelievable. But as for giants, I think maybe people might be exaggerating the size of some spiders. I mean, it happens all the time. Someone will say there's a huge spider in the bathroom, and then you go in and it's not that big. I mean, to some, 5 centimeters toe to toe is a giant, but there you go. Once again, huge thanks to Truth is Scarier Than Fiction for helping with this video. You should definitely check out their channel, as it is full of great cryptid content. If you thought giant spiders in the Congo is interesting, then check out their video on this giant snake in the Congo. Once again, thanks to my patrons, and thanks for watching.